Test 8, Section 1, Question 1. The best answer is A. When the passage starts, it mainly explains the narrator's love of reading. Even then, my only friends were made of paper and ink. At school, I had learned to read and write long before the other children. Where my school friends saw notches of ink on incomprehensible pages, I saw light, streets, and people. The rest of the paragraph goes on to explain the narrator's love of reading. In the fourth paragraph, the paragraph retreats this love in its description of a bookshop. When the writer states, "It smelled of old paper and dust, it was my sanctuary, my refuge." However, there is a shift of focus. In the sixth paragraph, when the narrator is introduced to Great Expectations by Charles Dickens, this gift of a book transforms the narrator's love of reading into a desire to write. When he states, "I did not think there could be a better one in the whole world, and I was beginning to suspect that Mr. Dickens had written it just for me. Soon, I was convinced that I didn't want to do anything else in life but learn to do what Mr. Dickens had done." Thus, the passage's overall focus, can be said, shifts from the narrator's love of reading to a specific incident that influences his decision to become a writer, something that choice A suggests. Choice B is incorrect because the passage never focuses on the narrator's father, who primarily serves to illustrate the narrator's determination to read books despite all obstacles. Choice C is incorrect because the passage focuses on the narrator's desire to write rather than on whatever skill he may have as a writer. And choice D is incorrect because the passage doesn't make the narrator's childhood hardships its central focus or analyze the effects of those hardships.